Yom Kippur meditation. Breathing into oneness. It is almost Yom Kippur, the Day of Atonement, the Day of Oneness. Of returning to where we began, completely one, without duality of consciousness, without you and I, without us and them, without good and evil. When all was truly good. Our journey is a journey of breath. Breath is the rhythm of the life force to move from the duality into the oneness. So on this day, Yom Kippur, we do not fast. We simply do not need to eat. We have no need of food. We do not fast of drinking. We have no need of liquids. We have no need of bathing. We have no need of speaking vanity. We have no need of animal clothes. We are not from a world of animals. We are pure soul. Pure thought, pure mind. On Yom Kippur, we breathe through all these levels like floors in an imaginary building. We look at the lies, our bodies have convinced us that who is the master? The desire for food, the desire for drink, the desire for power over another. These are the masters. And they are false. On Yom Kippur, they disappear and prove their falseness. Breathing into oneness. Exhaling multiplicity. Removing duplicity, receiving unity. Breath is the vehicle through time, through the wall of time, on the other side of time is the timeless. Breathe and release our notions of our masters. They are liars. They are jailers. They are magicians. For we are the masters of the things we do not need. In Yom Kippur, we need nothing but pure speech, pure intention, pure awareness. The Day of Atonement, the day of becoming one, leaving behind all judgments. Judgment implies duality. Judgment defies unity. In a dream, what do you need? Nothing. Awake. Why do I need more than nothing? We breathe. And remember that we do not remember, and thus begin a new memory. Of now, of oneness, precious, timeless, freedom. Not freedom. We need to run from nothing. We are God's image in this world. Breathe into that image. If you find this difficult, remember, you believe in so many other images. Why not breathe to the top image? Believe to the highest you. Why not? Because we have failed. Who says we have failed? The only failure is not trying. On Yom Kippur, we ask for forgiveness. And yet cannot remember that which we need forgiveness for. We are children. Masquerading as adults. discovering the desire to be pure and innocent and simple is most childlike and most profoundly mature and based on our true image. Let us pray, let us breathe, let us breathe until even breath itself is a function of the body, and the mind knows a much greater plane of food and drink and breath and body. We are drawn from God's thought, therefore we are thought. That which is not pure thought are merely the garments of our masquerade in this world of apparent duality. Let us be together on Yom Kippur, one, whole, complete unity. And so it will be.